Are you working with a therapist?
I've gone through a lot of therapists actually in my years. One of them actually was in New York. I think I actually made him scared.
What is going on here? There's a lot of people in the corner over here with cameras.
Well, I have a small camera team from Sweden here this week because we want to kind of like showcase my life on tour. We have a reality show called Parnevik in Sweden. We're now taping season 3 actually, but it normally just happens in our house in Florida. And we have politicians, rock star, movie stars, athletes, and whatever come and visit us for 3-4 days.
How is Swedish golf culture different from American golf culture?
Sometimes Swedish golf culture can be a little bit too sporty, I think. I mean, you can go out there in your short shorts, jogging shoes, and like a t-shirt, and be really sporty with like headband, wristbands. That's how you can see a golfer in Sweden. So they're trying a little bit too much to make it into a sport.
Right. What do you have to do in your life that you hate doing?
Would golf be one of them? Yeah, but golf is like a love-hate. And everybody that plays golf knows it's not only about pure love and passion. You know, there's no sport that can makes you hate the sport more than golf, I think.
Right.
And that goes with professionals as well. It's definitely a love-hate relationship. And in a way, sometimes it's nothing more I hate than golf.
If you're like on the cut line, but you're not feeling it, do you ever just hit one OB?
I can't do that, no. It's like, even if I want to, like even if the something...
You've thought about it.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I mean, if you know it's something really fun going on that night or whatever, and but I just can't help, I can't do it. It's like if you would have like a 6-footer last hole, you know, if I miss this, I will miss the cut. It's like, it's subconscious. I make it anyway. I can't do it on purpose. I don't know why. And I think a lot of guys are like that. It is tough to tank it.
So it's like you just have to love golf one notch more than you hate it.
Yeah, and that notch is very tough to find sometimes. It's, you know, anybody that plays golf knows that, you know, you can have a real shitty day, miss shots, shank, OB, flush on 18, and you go like, wow, I love this game, then want to come back tomorrow. And then, like, you snap hook the first tee shot, and you go like, that wasn't it either. And that's just golf.
What do you say after a bad shot?
Since I lived over here a long time, I use the F word sometimes. But I'm lucky being from Sweden, though, because if I happen to say it out loud, f**k and tack. Tack is thank you in Swedish. I always say, if they're about to find me, I say tack, which is, you know, thanks for that shitty shot I would explain it with, so I get away with it.
So you can alter one letter and potentially save a lot
thousands
of money.
Thousands of bucks, which I've done through the years, yeah. But, yeah.
Would you rather play golf for the rest of your life but make no money, or play golf one more time?
You can stop right there.
That's what you do.
That's a no.
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 You wouldn't, if you didn't make any more money, you would stop playing golf.
Oh, in a heartbeat, yeah. What? Like, I went past the stage when golf is like you play for fun when I was like 18.
Really?
No, but like, man, there's so many things in life you can do. I mean, I've played golf now for 40 years. Why would I keep doing that just for free? Or not?
Maybe
I mean,
this is why you're so angry.
That's what I mean. So it's not worth the anger and the therapy sessions just if you can't, you know, pay for it, if you don't make no money.
Given your feelings about golf, I'm a little hesitant to ask this question, but what is your favorite part of golf?
I can't see any other area in life that would test you as much as golf either. So that's why I think everybody loves golf. That's why you see take out their athletes when they take them to Michael Jordan or take all the hockey players, tennis players, all the guys that kind of quit their career or end their career and they really want to try to become good golfers.
Right.
Have you ever seen so many frustrated athletes being good at one sport and trying to play golf? Because they realize this is probably the toughest sport I ever tried.
Right.
But that's the beauty with it, because you can never perfect your game. And that thing. So that's when you say, what do you love? I love golf for that. Just the seeking the secret, seeking like the new thing, seeking a solution for what your duck hook or slice or whatever. So a session on the range, I love that at the same time. Kind of like you're trying to break a bank or hacking a computer. You're trying to hack golf. And that's what I love at the same time.
Based on your history with Justin Leonard, do you think his entire life purpose is to piss you off?
Well, the big one was in British Open when he played that great last round that we can be nothing but impressed by. But Then he kicked my ass in the Ryder Cup once too. Well, then he beat me in a playoff at the Texas Open. Oh, you're right. I don't like that guy.
Did you have any questions for me or anything?
No.
Okay.
I just want to get out of here.